I want to now turn to John Kasich as Donald Trump and Ted Cruz battle it out on the debate stage Saturday night. Underdog candidate John Kasich arguably had one of his best debate performances so far in the race. Watch him here, everyone.
If I get elected president, head out tomorrow and buy a seatbelt, because there's going to be so much happening in the first 100 days, it's going to make your head spin, and we're going to move America forward. I promise you.
Well, the Ohio governor did receive several rounds of applause for his stay positive strategy in New Hampshire, and he is now swaying our next guest, television host Montel Williams. Montel, good to see you.
Hey, Trish, how are you? Good to see you again.
I'm doing really, really well. So here you are. You're saying that Governor Kasich is the first GOP candidate you've been excited about since you left the Republican Party back in the 90s?
Absolutely.
Tell me why.
Well, I think you can take a look at what happened Saturday night and look what's happened in the subsequent days. Have you not noticed clearly in every single commentator who's interviewed Donald Trump today has asked him the question, why has your tenor changed? And I think he understands why, because a person to jump from 4% in the polls to now 13% in the poll is clearly getting through and reverberating with the people on the ground in New Hampshire. Kasich is telling people really that there's an adult in the game now. That's the reason why I'm so excited about him, because at the end of the day, you said it, most of your guests earlier said it, you've got two extremes. You've got Bernie on one side and you've got Donald Trump on the other side playing to the base of reality TV. But the adults
so
are going to be
is,
the ones that are going to pull the I think Kasich
he's
is
got executive experience, by the way.
Executive experience. He's balanced two budgets, a state budget, a national budget. He's been on the defense committee. If I have to think about all of those veterans right now and all of those service members who are going to go out and vote, I think we would all like a commander-in-chief who's an adult, who's not going to be calling people names, who's not going to be throwing fits, who's not going to be cheating, who's not going to be lying. I'm so sorry. You know, you watch Mark Rubio and you watch Cruz and you watch Donald Trump. It's just one continuous banter of the children in the fringes of the playground. And then the adult walks in and says, stop. And they all go, huh? Well, then they all went, huh, on Saturday night, watching a man deliver a message of unity. Because remember, when the election's over, you know, you don't only run as president for 22% of the populace. It's for the entire country. Somebody's got to start talking already about how do we bridge these gaps and start to build bridges over the divides that everybody else is creating. And that's what John Kasich
Montel. How might he be able to capture New Hampshire's momentum if he performs well tomorrow as he moves forward to South Carolina and then on?
Just like what's happened today. All day long I've been home watching him be interviewed on every single outlet, because he rose above the chaff on Saturday night. We're giving him the platform that people never got to see before. I was in the gym today. A guy in my gym came up to me and said, Montel, did I hear you're back in Kasich? And I said, you know, yeah. And he said, well, you know, I've been doing it all along, but I just thought he had no chance. Well, he does have a chance. If the media gives him an opportunity to talk to Americans who are trying to remember, in less than 11 months, we have to have a country that's going to come back together to deal with the problems that we have facing us. We're going to have a military that wants to go to war for us. And right now, when you have told people, I don't want you to be a part of my country, the same people who have served for us, you know, we need to start thinking about what's going to happen next year, not what's happening today. And I think that's
Let me just ask you, since I have you here, what is it that discouraged you about the party in the last several years that John Kasich is now basically helping you to wash away?
It's been an absolute party in the last, I tell you, 15 or 20 years that didn't want to include me. Listen to me, you know, I got 22 years in the military. I'm as conservative as they get. You know, remember, I'm the guy who's every day trying to stick my nose into the lives of our soldiers. There's an airman and Marines, whether they be having trouble at hospitals or having troubles overseas. I'm a Republican true to the heart, but I can't serve because I don't get invited to the party. You don't like me because maybe the color of my skin. You don't like me because maybe my attitude on one or two issues isn't exactly like yours. John Kasich is a leader who recognizes we don't have to agree on everything, and we don't. But we can come together, have a discussion. He could take a piece of me, I can take a piece of him, and as long as it moves this country forward, you know, that's what I'm all about. And I think that's what a lot of people in America want. We want a country that's going to succeed, not a country that's going to be torn apart because of some people who have decided to divide the fringes.
Montel, thank you for sharing that with us. We'll be watching, of course, very carefully. I've said all along, they like him here.
He's
they
going
really
to surprise
do.
You
so
tomorrow.
We'll
I'm telling you, he's going to surprise you tomorrow.
Montel Williams, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.